Yeah, it's nice. Very early in the morning on the Feather River, and after a two-year closure, we're finally able to fish for Chinook salmon.
Want to come in.
And so far, this season is off to a great start.
Oh.
We're fishing with Raith Herford, who runs RH Guide Service, and he's anchored up on a seam just below the mouth of the Yuba River, where we can run lures like quickfish and flatfish, and also cast jigging spoons to cover more water.
Okay, what we're going to do here is we're going to slice a piece of the sardine off, and we're going to attach it to this flatfish here, and what we'll do is gives it a little more scent in that and create a bite. Anyways, we'll just cut this right here like this. About halfway down the sardine, you just fillet it off like this, and we're going to straighten it out so it lays nice and flat. Then you make a little slice up the middle. There you have it. And then you're going to take your flatfish and slide it right up the hook like that. And you want it lay nice and straight, just like so. And then we just tie it on. And you can stuff right here with crawdad or whatever you want to put in there. But we're going to put a little sardine pro cure on also. And we're just going to wrap it on real carefully. You go around the front side of the hook, nice and easy. Use your finger to kind of hold it straight. And you flip the hook forward like so, and then we're gonna go right behind it. I like to wrap it all, maybe 15 times on each side of the hook. And then I normally flip the hook back forward and do the last one right around the front. The last piece, the most important thing, so your line doesn't hang up on your hook. Stick your finger out, go around, and we're gonna go through twice, once. Twice, and it cinches right down on the bait. Okay, then you're gonna take a little pair of scissors so you don't tear your bait up and snip her off. There you go, nice baited. I know it's an old tore up lure, but it's been hooking a lot of fish lately right here. So we're gonna put that back out there and see if we can catch another one. Yeah, this is another lure we're using. Besides a quickfish, you use these spoons. P-Line makes this one, it's a real nice lure. It really shines a lot underneath the water. What you're trying to do is drop this in front of a salmon. And you can use a treble hook on a 1 ounce lure. Anything above an ounce, you have to use a single hook. And so we have a treble hook on this one. I don't know, either one, they both work the same. When they bite it, they bite it. But this is a P-line minnow. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna lob them out the side where we think the fish are coming through and laying, and then we're gonna try to drop that in front of it. Drop it in front of it, you'll get your bite. Once you feel your bite, you have to set the hook and you have to keep it tight. You don't keep it tight, he'll come off. He'll shake, that heavy lure will fall right out of his mouth. The advantage on these lures also is you can go into heavy timber, brush, sticks, you know, everything, and you drop these in there, and when you get hung up, you just tap it a few times and give it some slack, and normally it'll fall right out of the snags. But we're working a little runway right here, and we're just gonna lob them out there. You just lob them out there like that. And you want to keep your spool on free spool until it hits the bottom. That way you fall right where you toss is where your lure falls. And you just, like a yo-yo, tie it on the way up, tie it on the way down. When he comes up and grab it, he'll grab it on the drop. And then you reel it up and you make another cast. Right here, we're in 12 feet of water, so we're not lobbing them real far, but just off the side of the boat. You can have two rods. So we have one in the water with the flatfish, and then we're using a spoon with our other rod. Covers a little more water. Gives you a better chance to catch a fish. Where we're at here is we're below the Yuba River, and we have the water's cooler on the right-hand side of the river than it is on the left-hand. The water on the left-hand is running about 67 degrees. Fish on, fish on, fish on, fish on, fish on. Oh, fish off. Fish off, go ahead, reel it in. But what I was just saying, the water on the right-hand side of the river is about 5 degrees cooler than the water on the left-hand, so we're sitting right on the water line. And that's the third fish this morning that we've had on. One of them right to the boat, but they're just not biting it, you know, they're not biting the quickfish hard enough. But yesterday, day before, they were taking it all the way down, we weren't hardly losing any, but that's three fish already this morning, so. We'll have one in the boat here pretty soon, though.
Welcome back to the Feather River. I'm Justin Wolf. We're with guide Ray Thurford fishing for Chinook salmon just above Shanghai Bend and below Yuba City, California. And so far, there's been a good early morning bite going on.
Nice fish, Ron.
It's a big one, too. We're in the Feather River, so this year we have a one-month season to catch these salmon. And it's getting better every day, too. The fishing's really good right now. The problem is it's not in yet. It's getting close. You could drop anchor and float them out, but we haven't had any problem landing them till today. But if you drop anchor and you float them out, you get right on top of them. But this way you get a lot more fight out of your fish. He's being real easy with him. That's just the way you want to fight these salmon. You don't want to tear the hooks out. We're on the anchor because we're on this water line. And right here, the fish seem to be running like a path. And every day they come up this same little path. And so we're sitting right here on the anchor just waiting for them to come. When there's not a lot of fish, you're going to get right in their runways and just wait them out. We call it grinding it out. So otherwise you'd be back trolling or hole dropping in from hole to hole and going from different areas. But the fish seem to be coming up this path, so we're just going to hold right here. This is the fourth fish of the day, and as you can see, the sun's just now coming up.
Big fish too.
That's a different one.
Oh my goodness.
There was a different fish out there. Did you see that? Yeah, his fish came up over here, and there was a fish over here.
25 pounder.
Yeah, nice fish.
Nice fish.
We both
Somebody's
lost a fish.
Break the jinx.
I did, and Ron over there. So, I think this is the first one coming in.
Is he pinned? Ronnie, is he pinned shut?
What's that?
Is he pinned in pretty good?
Looks like it.
Fish on over here. Oh, we just had a double. Just had a double going. The spoon, you can keep fishing those. They're easy to get in and out of the way, but when somebody's fighting a fish. But we just had one on a spoon too. It's the fifth fish we hooked today, and we yet to land one. Here he comes. Yeah.
That one didn't go well.
Well, you weren't joking about a little fishing hotspot.
Yeah, no, it's been a...
That's why we had to be here at 4:45 nice in the morning, huh?
Yeah, no. You know, he stayed the night.
I know. Didn't want anybody to get his spot.
Well, you know, it is what it is. Sometimes you have to stay the night out here if you really want your hot spot, but you know, it's worth it in the morning.
Yeah, I just picked up the rod and started pumping the flatfish. Just got nailed right away. Amazing.
Yeah, the fish is doing a lot of turns in that behind the boat. If we wanted to drop anchor, we could already have that fish. This way, they'll fight harder.
Keep Can we make riding. Some wagers?
Take your time with him, Storm. He's pinned. Pin him out. Fish has a lure pretty good. I could probably get him right now. You don't want to net him green. There we go. Silver fish. That's perfect health. Todd laid the rod down and he let the fish go back under the water. See how he's laying it down? That keeps the fish from coming up top and pulling the hooks out. Okay, now he's going to walk them right back to me. Here we go, right here. Lift him up. And he's got one more little run left.
Yeah. That's how you do it.
Nice, nice fish.
Look at that silver that is.
Nice silver fish. K16, the one we just wrapped up, it's the same flatfish. It's been bit twice this morning, so we're going to be wrapping that up again here in a second, putting it back out. It's the hot lure. It's a K16, quick fish. We've got changed out hooks. They're not the stock hooks, but what a beautiful salmon.
Due to low returns in previous years, salmon fishing has been closed on the Feather River for the past 2 years. But this year, we have a one-month season to catch king salmon.
Yeah, these are Chinook or a king salmon. They're not really a silver salmon, but what we're saying is they're nice and silver. They're real bright, real fresh, nice clean fish. So they're right out of the ocean, just, you know, a few days out. The biologist said they can run up here in a couple days. So it's about 70 miles of river, but no big deal. We'll get back there and get another one.
All right, this is what everybody's calling the pickle. I actually thought that was the name of the bait. I don't know much about this salmon fishing, but I'm learning.
That one just stopped the lure from working. The lure was, and it just stopped. And I set the hook and it was fish on. Here goes the fire drill. Big fish, big fish. Big fish, boy, he's pumping. Yeah, we had the early morning bite going and it was real good, but there's an afternoon bite here also. About 10, 11 o'clock, we've been catching a bunch of fishmen coming through. What happened was there was a bunch of fish laying over to the left and the boat traffic went over the top of them and shoved them right over to us. So nice big fish all day long until about 1 o'clock you can catch fish. And then late in the evening, it's real good. Boy, he's coming up on top. A lot of fun, king salmon, Feather River.
That is a nice fish. Yeah. You see, the lucky one? That was on the
corner. Hold it right over there. Right in the corner. Walk in the corner. Now we found that lure floating down the river and we put a new bait on it, and we figured somebody must have hooked one on it and broke it off, because it was a nice new lure, changed out hooks. And so we rewrapped it, put it on, and that's the second fish on that lure. Where's my netter?
Come on, Kenny.
Yeah, I got this one on a spoon. I was flipping it off the side of the boat. Little jack salmon. Look at my... So much for my netter. Get the net out of the water. You want to run your pole underneath the boat when they do that. Get the net out of the water. Walk back there. Little guy, he's just a little jack salmon. He came up and popped it. Got a good hook set on him. Here we go, right here. Hold him right there. And what we did, I was throwing the spoon, and these single hooks, you can come in here like this, and the single hook, I mean, he's hooked good. Just one hook right through the corner, and that's normally what it does. And I was just pitching it off the side. We haven't caught a fish in a while. Threw it over there. It's a nice little pretty jack. I'm gonna back it out like that. The hook just falls out like so. But another nice clean fish. So you just keep working hard, you keep pitching them spoons. If you get it in front of the fish, he'll bite it. If he bites it, then you know, you got him. But we're using these P-Line Predator minnows, and you know, they're just a lot of flash to them. And if you can get it in front of the fish, you know, they'll grab it. I got 20-pound P-Line, you know, the fishing line, and then with the Predator minnow, deadly combination.
What Wraith is calling a predator minnow is actually a P-line laser minnow, which is not only extremely effective on salmon,
of course, mine's bigger,
but also on striped bass.
He's going to have to throw his back. I'll be able to eat mine. But these little minnows, P-line minnows, they're working really well.
After this break, we're fishing for striped bass on the Sacramento River with Wraith Herford.
Nice little one on the worm.
Sacramento River striped bass can be fished for in many different ways, including plastic worms, trolled lures, and live bait. But one of the most effective, fun, and easy way to catch striped bass is with the jigging spoon. such as the P-line laser minnow, which imitates a wounded bait fish. This morning, we're with guide Ray Thurford and Benny Rehnquist, who have mastered the art of jig fishing for Sacramento River striped bass.
We're going to be working the laser minnow back. What we're going to be doing is we're just going to be back trolling. We know there's been a lot of fish laying in this flat. It's just a nice 12-foot flat that just goes straight down the river. But what's happening, the fish are grouping up. They're starting to spawn. So all you want to do is just drop this back and ease it through the schools, and they'll do the rest for you. We're just doing a slow back troll and retrieve. We got the kicker engine on as low as it'll go, and we're barely falling back, as you can tell, along the bushes with this minnow. And all the fish are gonna think, they're just gonna think it's a dying minnow falling next to them. So we'll just back her down here and see what happens. What we're looking for is a ball of fish, because they're starting to group up to spawn, and we're gonna target this straightaway right here. They've been balled up in here for the last couple days, about 10 feet of water. We're just gonna slowly back troll it down through him. He's definitely a good fighter. We're gonna see him here in a second. There he is. Nice striper.
Fish on. Oh, another good one.
Nice striper on a spoon. Now on these spoons, just grab the top of the spoon. Benny's got one right here on a rubber worm also.
Little bitty guy.
You know, you can catch them on a spoon, you can catch them on the rubber worm. Either one, when you're in the right spot, this is a great technique. You just drop these down into a deep little shelf, and you pick up some nice fish. Of course, mine's bigger, so you know, he's gonna have to throw his back. I'll be able to eat mine. But these little minnows, P-line minnows, they're working really well. You know, have great luck on them. Anytime you have a little drop off in the river, you just put one of these on, drop it over the side, and back troll it down like we were doing earlier, and you can pick up your limit stripers real easy. And you can catch fish after fish on them. They're real durable and lasting lure. But yeah, another nice keeper. Get back at it. We just come down river and there's a nice soft, this water's real soft right here. The water's going both directions. It's going back up river and it's going down river. That's a perfect spot to look for when you're wanting to spoon fish, because what's happening, that's a good place for the bait to hold up. But what we're trying to do is we're trying to work the water line. We're finding a deep drop off, and we're gonna drop these spoons right down the drop off, and you just want them to bounce off the bottom. You wanna drop them down, you drop them all the way to the bottom. Just as they hit the bottom, you're gonna pick them up and you're gonna set it back down. You pick it up just like a yo-yo. I tell all my clients that you just wanna hit the bottom, pick it up like a yo-yo, click it over, and every once in a while you're gonna open your spool up, you let a little more line out, it'll hit the bottom, boom, it hits the bottom. And then you're just gonna jig it right in front of the fish. You just be right on top of them. What will happen, the fish will come up and they'll think the minnow's dying, and they'll come up and you'll get a reaction bite. You'll catch nice fish. But you wanna look for the drop-offs in the river, and then where the water kind of softens up, like you got fast current out here, you got soft current over here, and you're just gonna get right in between it, work your way right down and in between it, and you should be able to pick up the fish that are holding in there. Couple nice fish on a P-line lure.
Ray Thurford also guides incredible flooded rice, duck, and goose hunts near the Sutter Refuge Sanctuary. And right now, you can book exclusive Angler West TV hunts with RH Guide Service.
We got some birds above us right now. That was a big mallard right there, and it was a single duck, so this time of year, you know, a lot of singles come around in the fog and that, but you're liable to kill anything out here. We are set next to the close zone at Sutter Refuge on Bell Farms property, and what's going on is you get ducks floating off the close zone all the time, and they get out in these fields, and that right there was a big mallard. The last one we shot was a teal. Today in the fog, you never know what we're going to kill. Come up. Drop him. Go lay down. Back. Go lay down. No jewelry. A lot of times you'll be sitting here and you'll just watch down there and you'll see your dog's head move. And just by the way he's looking, you can tell that he's watching birds.
coming in, so you'll look that direction and there'll be birds right there just working their way in your decoy. So you know, a lot of different guides in that, and a lot of different hunters, they can sit here and look one way and they can watch their dog look over the top of him and he'll be looking the other way, and they'll know when birds are coming just by the way their head's moving and the look in their eye. So you can just, like I said, a lot of times just watch your dog and you'll know when birds are coming in the other direction. So you got an extra set of eyes. When your dog's been out hunting as often as our dogs hunt, then you get used to their habits too.
Pup, back! Pup! Get the bird! Come here! Come here! Come! Hey! Gadwall.
Oh, pup!
Bring him here, baby. Bring him here. Bring him here. Bring him here.
Go to anglerwesttv.com for information or call 530-510-0514.
Big gadwall.
There's a limited number of openings available and they will go fast, so call or go online today.